next this morning, you know.
Well, now, until we find out what it's like for young people who have just got a job as they begin settling in, the first stage in going to work.
Listen, has Stephen found a job yet? Oh, dear. Yes. Mm. Edward starts at the motorcycle shop tomorrow. Yes, we're all ever so pleased about it. Do you want to wish him luck? Righto. Well, perhaps you'll phone me when you've got yourself straightened out. I give that Jason a big kiss from me. Oh, and give my regards to Steve, of course. Righto. Bye-bye.
Didn't she want to speak to me?
Oh, she was in a rush. Everything's upside down with this move. She wished you luck, though.
I don't see why we're all wishing him luck. Well, they probably won't trust him with much more than sweeping the floor.
That's enough of that, Gary. Eddie's done very well to get this job.
It's not a job, it's a training scheme. And you're guaranteed one of those when you're 16.
It might turn into a job at the end of the year.
Maybe. It just all seems a bit cockeyed to me. Everyone's always going on about staying on at school, getting qualifications.
Well, it's still the best way if you can do it.
Well, if it's that clever, why don't they pay for you to stay on in the sixth form? Same as them schemes. They don't guarantee 18-year-olds anything. Except a place on a dole queue, maybe.
Let's not go into all that again. You know that the careers gentleman said you had a good chance of getting a job.
Yeah, I might get a job. But after 2 years hard slog for nothing. I'm going to bed.
Oh, dear.
Now, you'll be issued with logbooks as part of your assessment. You'll be expected to make a note of everything that you're asked to do, what you've learned, and your comments, if you have any, each week. You bring your logbooks to me or to Mrs. Mansfield or whoever the acting organiser is if I'm not here every Friday lunchtime. Is that clear?
You sure you want to hear what we think of it all, Mr. Prentice?
What I want doesn't come into it, lad. It's part of the assessment. But I'll tell you now, I like a joke as much as the next man, but I am not partial to cheekiness. Take the warning.
Yes, Mr. Prentice.
Now, while you're in my department, we shall be making out reports for personnel about how you're progressing. This will help the company to assess what you're good at and where you're best suited.
Do we get to see your reports, sir?
No, they're internal matters.
That don't seem very fair. You see ours.
You'll know soon enough if we're not happy with you. Now, are there any other questions?
No.
Now, well, the rule is here, if you don't know, you ask, but don't go asking silly questions. We're a busy department, nobody's got time. Now then, Mrs. Mansfield, we'll show you the locker room before you go down. Mrs. Mansfield.
Okay. Would you come this way?
Good luck, everybody.
Thanks. Now, you each get your own locker. Money, jewellery, or anything valuable should be put in there at the beginning of the day. The company can't accept liability for stuff that's left lying around. If you've got any sense, you won't bring anything that's worth much anyway.
Oh, you're here, are you?
Yeah, brought some more clothes.
You won't be needing them today. There's a batch of spares in the back here. Get them unloaded and into the shop. Have you used one of these before?
No.
You set the price here, see? And you just stick them on. You find a price list under the counter. Just mark them all up and fill in the display where we're getting low, okay?
Is there anyone I can check with if I'm not sure?
Now, Marge is serving this morning, but I wouldn't ask her unless you're desperate. She's as thick as two short planks.
Have you got a minute just to show us where everything goes, then?
Use your initiative, lad. You're here to learn. Up to my eyes this week. I haven't got time to run around after you.
Stan?
What now?
Will I get a chance to work on the bikes later?
When we're not so busy, maybe. You'll only get in the way this morning. And there's plenty for you to do in the shop. Look lively, then. You can give the pickup a wash when you're finished. Fed up with kids writing in the dirt on it.
And nobody's allowed to make personal calls on this telephone, OK? There's a call box for that outside the canteen. This phone is in use for work all day. If you do have to answer it, then you're our link with our customers, so we expect you to be polite and efficient. You say, hello, Newell and Booth, can I help you?
Hello, Newell and Booth, can I help you?
Shut up, Winston. You make a note of all calls in this book here, OK? And that includes the time of the call, the name of the caller, whether they're going to ring back or they want us to ring them, and your name, OK?
What sort of things will they be asking about, Miss?
Deliveries, mainly. If you can get them to give you an order number, you can check it in this delivery book here and tell them when their stuff is due to go out, or maybe why it hasn't arrived.
Supposing they ask us something we don't know, though?
Well, then you tell them you get somebody who can deal with it. Oh, and don't forget to ask them if they prefer to hold on or have us ring them back later, OK? You're going to remember all this, are you, Winston?
Oh, yeah, I've got a photographic memory.
Maybe, but we still like you to write all telephone numbers down. And don't forget to repeat them back to the caller, just to check that you've got them right, OK?
Yes, Mum.
I've washed the van.
What do you want, a medal?
Can I help with the bikes now?
No, go and give Marge a hand. Cleaning up in the shop, it looks a mess in there.
I thought I was here to learn.
So you are.
Well, I've been washing my dad's car for years, so I already know how to do that.
Well, I hope you do a better job on his motor than you've done on this pickup. Look, the first thing you've got to learn, Eddie, is that in any business, you start at the bottom and you do what you're told.
OK.
Oh, there is something else you can do, though.
Yeah?
Get a cup of tea on for me and Fred. We're parched out here.
What's for dinner tonight, love?
I don't know. I was hoping you might have got something together for a change. After all, I'm at work all day.
I've had plenty to do as well, you know. I had to finish off the unpacking, then I went down the job centre to see if there was anything worth going for. Then there's Jason to feed and change.
Yeah, OK. I'll put on some spaghetti in a minute.
What are you doing?
I told you, the new trainees mean a lot of extra work. I'm just sorting out the assessment forms.
They take advantage of you, you know, that firm.
Hmm?
The amount they're paying you. You shouldn't have to be bringing work home.
Well, no one asked me to do it. I just wanted to get it done.
Still angling for the organiser's job, eh?
Yeah, I am.
Look, I tell you what. Forget about cooking. I'll go and get some fish and chips, eh?
Don't bother.
Why, it's no bother. I mean, like you said, you don't feel like cooking after a hard day's work.
I don't much feel like eating expensive takeaway food all week either. Oh, look, Steve, we're going to have to sort this out between us, you know.
What do you mean?
Well, I think you should take on most of the housework while you're out of a job.
I'm not going to be out of work forever, you know.
But I never said you were. In the meantime, it'd just be fairer, that's all.
Oh, you don't appreciate what I do do. I mean, most boats can't even change a nappy. I do my share.
The washing up's still sitting in the sink from breakfast.
Oh, you'll be bringing me home an apron next.
Look, I don't want to nag you, Steve. I mean, we ought to be a team. That's what marriage is about. Just at the moment, I'm working and you're not. That'll change very soon, I know, but in the meantime, we ought to sort it out fairly between us. It won't hurt you to do a little bit of washing once in a while, you know. It won't make you any less of a man. Not to me, anyway.
Well, you'd better get a move on, Edward. You don't want to be late for the shop.
I'm not going to work.
Oh.
It's my day for college and I got half an hour before I have to leave.
What sort of things will they be teaching you?
It's something called life and social skills. I'm supposed to be learning about opening a bank account and budgeting to start with.
Oh, that'll be interesting.
I don't see why. I'll never have any money left at the end of the week to bank anyway.
Do you get any sort of qualification out of it?
It's all part of the whites, yes. You get their certificate.
Yeah, you and half a million others.
Now then, Gary.
I'm not interested in any of it. I just want to work with bikes.
You can turn that off.
Mum!
the hell's going on? Right, in my office, the three of you. And you can leave that thing in the waste bin. Right, I'd like to know what's going on here.
Mr. Brent, you first, Claudia. Well, we were packing up the T-shirts like you told us, and everything was going okay, and then we opened up this one batch and there was a dead rat in it.
We didn't bring it in, Mr. Prentice.
Okay, so we started larking about with it, but someone else put it in there.
Yes, yes, I believe you. I should maybe have mentioned before that when you get new people starting in a factory, especially young people, some folk think it's funny to start playing practical jokes on them.
I nearly had a heart attack when I saw them.
Yes, well, anything like this happens again, you come and tell me and I'll sort it out.
Yes, Mr. Prentice.
Whatever happens, there is no excuse for turning my department into the school playground, and I will not put up with it. I'll have you thrown out, YTS or no YTS. Is that clear?
Yes, Mr. Prentice.
Now, you finish packing them T-shirts. I'll go and do a bit of rat catching of my own. No?
Sorry, Penny.
You shouldn't have done, because you know... Eddie!
Hello, Dad.
I thought you were supposed to be in college. What have you been doing all morning?
Well, I did go to college. Just didn't fancy it.
Oh, don't be stupid, Eddie. It's part of the scheme. You've got to do it.
I've made up my mind. I'm not going again.
But you haven't given it a fair chance yet.
They keep picking on me.
Well, who does? The teachers?
This bloke. He says I shouldn't go to the same class as the others. I should do work on reading and numbers.
See?
I can read. I'm not stupid.
Oh, of course you're not. But maybe you could do with a bit of help.
I just want to work with bikes, that's all.
Yeah, well, whose idea was it, these extra classes?
Careers bloke recommended it. It's not compulsory, though. There's other classes that can do it for one.
Well, there you are, then.
But they'll all take the mickey out of me now, though, if I can't keep up.
Look, if you let that worry you, you'll never learn anything new. Besides, most people are too busy trying to make a good impression themselves to worry about you. Look, I've got a bit of time. I'll give you a lift back to college.
I told you, I don't want to go.
I'll do a deal with you. Give it a fair chance. Say, what, 3 or 4 weeks? Then if you're still set against it, well, I'll sort things out with your mum and everyone. You'll need someone to speak up for you. Hmm?
Okay.
Voila.
Looks terrific.
Well, they say men make better cooks than women, don't they?
It even tastes good.
Well, don't sound so surprised. Cheers.
Cheers. Matter of fact, we have got something to celebrate.
Oh, yeah?
They're not going to advertise the old organiser's job. They've given it to me.
Oh, congratulations.
You are pleased for me, aren't you, Steve?
Yeah, yeah, of course I am. You're a very clever girl.
It's not that I don't believe in you, you know. You'll find something else soon, I know you will.
Yeah, maybe.
You will.
In the meantime, you're right, you know, it won't do me any harm to keep myself occupied. I thought I may be giving this place a lick of paint, you know, cheering it up a bit.
Good idea.
I've got some colour charts if you want to see. Mm. I've marked the ones I like.
I'd better take your advice, then. You'll be telling me men make better decorators than women, too.
Oh, you're OK. It's just so you get more over yourself than you do over the walls.
Actually, there was something else I wanted us to talk over.
Oh, yeah?
I fixed an appointment to see the doctor on Saturday.
Well, you're not ill, are you?
No, I wanted to talk to him about family planning. Well, I don't reckon we're going to want another baby for a couple of years, so, well, I thought perhaps I'd better go on the pill or have the coil fitted or something.
It's because of this job, isn't it?
Well, I've got a good chance. I don't want to blow it by getting pregnant. You do understand that, don't you, Steve?
Yeah, I think it's the right decision, but the wrong reason. Whatever we decide should be because of us, not because of a job.
Listen,
Barry Sheen, that's a customer's bike.
Sorry, Stan.
Sorry isn't good enough. I gave you enough work to be getting on with.
Well, I haven't done any harm.
You better not have, because you'll be the one that's paying for it. You've not had much of a first week, have you?
I've done my bit.
Not from where I'm standing, you haven't.
Well, that's because you never give me anything interesting.
I've given you jobs that needed doing.
Oh, yeah, stuff that no one else wants.
Look, the other trainee, Mark, he's shaping up all right.
Yeah, but I come here because I love bikes. I want to work with them, learn about them.
Yeah, Mark's just the same.
But you never let us near him.
I told you, you've got to start from the bottom. But Mark's doing one of those ACU courses Tuesday nights. It's only a few quid. They teach you riding and repairs.
Well, I thought I was coming here to learn.
Well, so you are, but it doesn't stop you showing a bit of keenness outside. You'll probably let Mark start helping out in the maintenance bay in a few weeks.
And what about me?
When you're ready.
Oh, yeah.
Look, it's skilled work, Eddie. You can't even mark up the prices on spares properly yet. I had to redo that whole display Tuesday. I was here till 8 o'clock.
I would have done it again if you'd asked me.
I might have done if you hadn't bunked off early. Look, it's time you got something into your head, lad. We don't run this place for your convenience. It's a business, see? We've got customers to think about. And you'll have to do what you're told, when you're told. That's how you learn. And if you don't like it, you know what you can do.
Excuse me. Look, while it's a bit slack, there's a couple of things I want to ask you about.
For the logbook.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Did you make a note of that stuff about the delivery book?
Yeah, it's the invoices I'm not sure about.
Now it all to you, Winston.
Oh, yeah. I don't need to make those stupid notes. I got it all in my head.
Dad?
Get the kettle on, will you? Make us a cup of tea.
I wanted to talk to you.
Well, I'm a bit busy at the moment. Can't I wait?
It won't take a minute.
Okay, fire ahead.
Can you lend me some cash?
Well, what's it for this time? More cassettes?
No.
Well, why can't you use the money you're getting from the YTS?
I'm gonna buy a ladder and some buckets and leathers. I wanna start my own window cleaning business. It's a good idea, isn't it?
But what about your job?
Oh, didn't you hear Gary? It's not a job, it's a scheme, and they're not gonna keep me on at the end of it. Don't seem worth going in there just to get picked on.
But you can't change your mind that quick, Eddie. You've got to give yourself a chance to settle in.
What's the point? They've all made up their minds that I'm thick and the other trainee's a genius. They won't change their mind.
Then you've got to prove them wrong. Talk to your mother about all this.
You know what Mum's like.
Mm. She sent you off with a flea in your ear.
I thought you'd understand. I mean, if I was working for myself, it'd all be different.
It won't be any picnic, you know, Eddie.
But at least if I worked for myself, if I tried hard, I'd be the one who'd make the profit out of it.
But supposing this doesn't suit you either. Employers don't like kids who keep chopping and changing.
I'm really going to make a go of this, Dad. I thought it all through. All I need's a bit of capital to start me off.
Oh, you've got a minute before you go to lunch, Kay?
Yeah, of course. I'm having sandwiches today, anyway.
Oh, good. Me too. No, I want to go through these reports on the trainees' first week.
Oh. Cheese and chutney?
Ham and pickle. Go on, help yourself. And some coffee?
Please.
No, they're not a bad bunch of kids, I suppose. We could have done a lot worse.
Mm. They seem to be settling in all right.
Do you collect their logbooks?
Mm. All except Winston's, who wanted a minute to finish. It said he'd bring it in before he went to lunch.
I'll look at these later.
Mm. You still reckon Claudia's the most promising?
Well, she's certainly a hard worker. What's her logbook like?
Oh, just what you'd expect. Very thorough. Goes into a couple of pages. Everything they were asked to do, just the way they've been told to do it, was good. I preferred Brenda's, though.
Well, it seems as if Mr. Newell agrees with your judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Well, she's applied for a permanency in sales. He's going to give it to her.
Oh.
Of course, if I was cynical, I could say that it was because her father plays golf at the same golf club as the boss, but I'm sure that had nothing to do with it.
Does she know yet?
No, the governor will be passing on the glad tidings himself. Mm. Meantime, we're getting a new trainee, somebody called Barbara Parker. I wonder what she's like. Yes?
Here's my logbook, miss.
Oh, sorry, thank
you, Mr. Prentice.
Well, how does he compare?
Well, nobody could accuse him of being long-winded.
Let's hear it, then.
First week, okay, signed Winston.